Hello, my dear kids. Very good evening. This is Sundar Rabindranathan here. Hey guys, what's happening? How is everybody? So let me see who are all here. Hello, Saloni. Welcome back. Arnav, Abhimanyu. I am fine, beta. I am fine. Bharti, hi. Samiksha. Yasmin Shah. Montazir. Ankur, super happy to see all of you guys. You know what, you guys are always special. Not everyone, you know, kind of tries to spare some time, especially on a Sunday evening, that too, right? To learn more, to have fun learning. And you guys have taken that route, you have made that choice, and you are always special. Kudos and hats off to all of you for that. Arnav, beta, hi, hi, hi. Saloni, I am awesome. How are you? Okay. Atharv, I have seen you already. Probably you are some other Atharv, I don't know. But I remember an Atharv already. Shashwati, hi. Muntazir, Ladakh, I envy you. Such a lovely place. Santosh, hi Santosh. Alright guys, amazing to see all of you as usual. So kind of curious, right? Look at the topic. See, many a times we have always learnt about the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Right? What makes it really stand till now? Right, we used to wonder, what is the science behind it? Is there a science behind it, first of all? Correct? You getting me? So, now. Yeah? You guys are ready? Oh, okay. Sorry, Atharv. My bad then. Hi, Abhinav. Thank you. So let's start, right? Let's understand, why doesn't the Leaning Tower of Pisa fall? Okay, before that, let us start. I'll set the context. Guys, it has been almost 800 years. This particular construction has seen several earthquakes, storms, wars, and it is still standing. Standing super solid, right? And there are people exclusively sitting and working, monitoring its inclination. Is there a change in its inclination? A bit of work has also been done on that. Alright, so it's not that all the time that the inclination is the same. Guys, all of you remember, the inclination of the Tower of Pisa earlier was a little different. Now it's a little different. Some work has already been done on that to ensure it stands still. Okay, it's going to be super interesting for you to understand. Oh, it's okay, Atharv. Aditya, hi. So, because there is something called critical inclination. Alright guys, I'll give you a simple example. Okay, listen to this, then before we start. But I think before that, we should actually start the session. Right? I don't know how many guys are new to Vedantu Young Wonders and you're watching this for the first time. So guys, this channel is dedicated to 6th, 7th and 8th graders. Okay, exclusively. And academically, we kind of got you covered on all four sides. What are the four sides? Mathematics, Science, English, Social. All four sides. Right? Entire year syllabus we cover. Everyday sessions happen. We are almost on the verge of completing this year's syllabus and starting the revision for full year. So very shortly that is going to start. So this is the perfect time for you guys to subscribe. Sir, apart from academics, what else is there? You will see a lot of content. Whatever you need, guys. You know what? As students, what do you aspire? Sir, I want to know more about sports. Or I want to know more about my comics, Marvel, you know, Avengers. as we say. I want to know a lot more about science fiction. I want to learn a lot more about space. Everything will be there. You know, you will see a lot of content for this in the channel. So don't miss it out, because everything lies in just one click of a button called subscribe. So do subscribe to the channel. And then, apart from subscribing, every day we want to know, right, what are the sessions that are happening today? So for you to get notified of the daily sessions, click on the bell icon. My dear Hasini, I'm sorry, right now we do not have Hindi, we are working on it, but yes, you know, मेरा हिंदी थोड़ा खराब है बेटा, सो दैट्स द रीजन आई ऑलवेज प्रिफर स्पीकिंग इन इंग्लिश. पीपल हु अटेंड माय लेक्चर्स ऑल द टाइम वी नो, एंड देयर इज अ टीम, इट्स नॉट जस्ट मी. यंग वंडर्स इज मेड ऑफ अ लवली सेट ऑफ पैशनेट टीचर्स. ओके, दीपिका आज नहीं है बेटा. नो नो नो. हाय मृत्युंजय, how are you? Okay, let's start. So what is the critical inclination and why the Leaning Tower of Pisa is not falling? Moving on. Ashwin, Santosh, right? Santosh. In Tamil, no, others have to understand, right? So now coming back, guys, listen. This is super important, because I'll help you understand this. Every object has a mass. I am there. I have my mass. I have my weight. Correct? Right. So this is my left hand. This is my left side. And this is my right leg. When I lean like this, I am leaning away from my base. Correct? Because here I don't have anything. I don't have my right leg, left leg, anything, nothing. But when I lean this side, alright, I have my right leg. So for any object, there is something called mass. There is something called center of gravity. All of you remember this. For any object, there is something called mass. There is something called center of gravity. Now tell me this. You see this picture right now, the Leaning Tower of Pisa, all of you. No, Habibullah, right now, no. It's a good idea, frankly. But not for every day we conduct mentee, sending certificates on a daily basis does not make sense. But what we can do is we can conduct periodically Maha Mentees or mentee contests, and whoever is winning, we can probably look at certificates for that. Yeah? Habibullah, does that sound like a good idea? So now, coming back to the picture. You see the Leaning Tower of Pisa, right? Okay. So the Pisa, this is the building. If it is leaning like this, can you tell me, I repeat, this is the building. If it is leaning like this, is it leaning away from its base or towards its base? My question is this. This is the Pisa, or this is the building. If the building is leaning like this, is it leaning away from the building or towards the building, towards the base? Come on. This is the base, right? This is the base. Now if it is leaning like this, is it leaning towards the base or away from the base? Away, everyone, right? So whenever an object moves away or leans away from the base, it reaches critical inclination, chances of it falling is high. It will fall. Right? Whenever an object leans away from the base, that means it is moving away from the center of gravity, likeliness of falling is high. It will fall. But when, you know, this is my base. Instead of this side, the object is falling like this, now tell me, is it falling, you know, leaning towards the base or away from the base? Towards. That means to save the object from falling, the base is there, the center of gravity will save it. Are you understanding what I am saying? Right? Is everyone understanding what I am saying? First of all, give me a yo so that I understand that you understand. Yeah? So any object has its mass, and any object has something called the center of gravity. So whenever an object moves towards the center of gravity, as long as it within the center of gravity, the chances of it falling is very less. Whenever it is moving away from the center of gravity, chances of its inclination becoming critical is very high. That means it can fall. Yeah, that's it guys, super simple. So all other things are for you to just grasp. So look at it. So every object has mass and center of gravity, right? Whenever you hold an object within its center of gravity, it's in perfect equilibrium. Because gravity, right, within the same torque. Torque is the force which pulls it, right? In any direction around that point, that is towards the center of gravity. So look at this, look at pictures A and B. Pictures A and B. So B, if you look at it, it is going towards the base. If you look at picture B, towards the base. So that means chances of it falling is very less. But look at D, it is going away from the base. My dear kids, I hope this is super simple and clear for all of you. Yeah? Hey guys, are you focusing? Cool. That is it, is super simple. So, if an object is exactly stands, you know, in its base, perfect equilibrium. It stands, even if it is leaning, it is standing or leaning towards its base. Picture number two, still perfect equilibrium will be there. Right? As long as it is leaning or right towards the base. Right? If the center of gravity is towards the base, then the chances of the object falling is less. But last, the moment the center of, look at the last arrow. The center of gravity is moving away from the base. That means it will push the object, it will incline it towards outside. It will pull the object outside the gravity, center of gravity. Cool? Hi Mohan, super happy to see you. Okay, awesome. So guys, give me a yo if you guys are super clear. Happy Sunday to you, Mohan, as well. See guys, look at the way we are spending our Sundays. We love spending the Sundays with all of you. All right. So, what is the mass of the Tower of Pisa? 14,500 metric tons. Right? So, it is center of mass. Somewhere it is in the floor to floor. The center of mass of the Pisa, Tower of Pisa. That means what? The center of mass is the location, the position which will hold the tower, which will decide, alright, how will it lean. So that is somewhere around the top of its fourth floor. Right? So, there is a team of engineers who keep working to ensure that the center of mass never goes, alright, away from the tower. The center of gravity is always kept intact. Alright, the center of mass, it's always kept and it aligns with the center of gravity. Even now. Look at that vertical line. How much is the tower leaning? right? The tower leans so much, the vertical line from its outer edge, which is at the top, meets the ground, there is a 4 meter difference. So inclination is almost like 4 meter difference from the base. The you know, it almost leans 4 meters, the Tower of Pisa. So guys, in 1990, it reached a critical inclination, 5 degrees. That means chances of it falling was very high. Look at the picture, guys. This is super interesting. Look at it. 1990, it had an inclination of almost 5 degrees. So the tower was coming close to a fall. Alright. Right. So the center of mass, which was there, almost like fourth floor, we were saying, right? So the inclination reached its critical level. So some engineering work was done on the lovely construction. Now they have reduced it to 4 degrees. From 5 degrees, now it is like 4 degrees, almost like, you know, from 1990 to 2001. Now it is kept within the center of gravity and it leads towards the base. So the chances of the Tower of Pisa falling is very, very less. My dear kids, are you understanding? I've tried to make it as simple as I can. Yeah? So, there is a team of people who are constantly monitoring the inclination. So, now they have done some work to ensure that it is like 4 degrees and it leans towards the base. So, the center of gravity falls inside the base. Ketan, we can, but you know what, the more you do it, it will not appear like a tower which is falling at all, which is leaning at all. It will appear like a straight tower. We have thousands of constructions like that. What is the speciality of it? So the speciality of this is, it is leaning. So when the moment you say 3 degrees and all, it doesn't look like leaning at all. Are you clear? So, the conclusion is, the leaning Tower of Pisa will not fall because its center of gravity is kept intact now. It is always towards the base, within the base. Okay? So, this is the reason why Tower of Pisa will not topple over. My dear kids, hit the like button if you are clear and if you like it. Sir, I am clear now. Now I know. It happens even if you are standing. If you want to stand and lean, if you want to know whether you will fall or you will not fall, the same principle will apply. Hi Chitramoni, how are you? Long time. Hi Abhishek. Akarsha, beta. Aaj menti nahi hai beta. You have to pardon me for that. I'll do it in the coming session. Okay guys, remember, you've got only 2 months left for a lovely revision, and this is a perfect time for you to create a revision plan, ensure you thorough master every concept of your syllabus, and do a lot of tests, assignments, etc. So, can Vedantu help you in any way? Yes. Vedantu has come out with a lovely subscription called Vedantu Pro. Guys, this subscription, as I said, we'll give you a lovely revision plan to master every concept because of our teachers. They make it super simple for you and fun. And we also make it, we ensure that live online quizzes, we fast track your preparation. Yeah, entire year syllabus, we fast track it in this 2 months time. And you see, whatever notes I given, right? If it is in Vedantu, in one click, you can download all my slides, all my notes, whatever I am writing in the board also. So it is super interesting. And doubts, as many as you want. Inside the class, we ensure all your doubts are solved. What more you want, guys? Assignments, why are assignments important? The more assignments you write, The more you write, first of all, the more it gets registered in your mind. You'll not forget. That's why me make you write more and more assignments. And needless to say, why are tests important? The more tests you write, you keep on writing tests. At one point in time, it's like a practice session for, you know, for you, for your final exam. The more you write, you know, at one point when your actual final exam comes, it is another test for you. Just like that, you will write and come. No exam fear. You will never forget anything out of fear. So take mock tests. That's the specialty. Thousands of micro courses also given absolutely free for you. Sir, what's a micro course? Micro course is concept wise, small modules given to you free. Clear? Okay. So welcome guys, 6th, 7th and 8th grade car crash course. So 15 day free trial is available. Math, physics, chemistry, biology, English, social, 6 subjects. 15 days of trial. So 7,000 rupees. 15 days of trial, fast tracked. And you know what, 15 days, I'll tell you something. 1,000 rupees for 15 days, 6 subjects. There is an option called apply coupon. You see an arrow mark hinting at that? Click on apply coupon. Type SRPRO. It becomes 800 rupees. 800 rupees, 6 subjects. Alright, 15 days time. What more you want, guys? Similarly, the full course from 7,000 become 5,600 the moment you apply SRPRO, the code. Classic is, alright, I'll tell you the difference between light and classic. Light is one where you get, you know, all the features except doubt solving outside the class. Classic is all these features will be there and doubt solving outside the class through a mobile app will also be there. That's the only difference. 8,000 rupees and 15 day trial is 1,400, but the moment you put SRPRO, it becomes 1,120 classic subscription, and from 8,000 it becomes 6,000 plus. Wow. All the best guys, make use of it. The link is there in the description box, SRPRO. SRPRO, the link is there in the description box. Make use of it, guys. Perfect time for you to subscribe, and more importantly, it's going to be truly, truly helpful for all of you. All the very best, guys. My best wishes to all of you. And join our Telegram group. Guys, you know what is so special about our Telegram group? First people, the in our community, who will get our updates. It could be any new series. It could be any initiative by Vedantu, Young Wonders. Everything comes to a Telegram group. Polls, what kind of series you want to launch. We will see a lot of surveys happening. Updates, all updates reach you first. Sir, how do I join? Type t.me/Vedantu Junior in your browser. Address bar, type t.me/Vedantu Junior. There you are, connected with us. Follow the instructions, that's it. All the very best, guys. So I believe now you know why doesn't the Leaning Tower of Pisa fall. Yeah. So one quick check, summary. Every object has a mass and center of gravity. As long as the object's inclination, that is extent to which it is leaning, is right, the center of gravity is kept towards the base, no problem. The moment it goes away from the base, there is a problem. It's called critical inclination. Alright, so that is it. Now, so Leaning Tower of Pisa has an inclination of only 4 degrees, and that too towards the center of gravity is towards the base. So the chances of it falling is not much at all. That's it, guys. So it was lovely, lovely interacting with you. I hope you are super clear on the concept. Hit the like button and let me know you liked it. Right, and do share the video, subscribe to, you know, the Vedantu Young Wonders channel as well, guys. Yeah, today we don't have mentee, guys. I will ensure that from next session we'll have mentee, okay? Thank you so much for watching. It was wonderful, wonderful interacting with all of you, especially on a Sunday evening. This is always special. I will meet you tomorrow in the session at 6 p.m. Until then, this is myself, Sundar Rabindranathan, signing off, kids. Take care. Bye-bye. Have a lovely Sunday evening.